In our previous video, we have solved this subnetting question number 6, where I have asked you to find out minimum 25 hosts with maximum subnets. Same like this, in our today's question, we are going to solve this subnetting question number 7. And here the question is, you are working with a network that has the network ID of 192.168.10.0, same like the subnetting question number 6. But here the requirement is 9 subnets for your company with the maximum number of hosts. What subnet mask should you assign? So from this particular one question, you have to find out which subnet mask should you assign so that you will get minimum 9 subnets with maximum number of hosts. How to solve this question? Let's find out. Hello friends, this is Abhishek here and welcome back to my channel Technical Tech. Let's the tech begin. Let me repeat the question once again. The question is, you are working with a network that has the network ID of 192.168.10.0 and the requirement is 9 subnets for your company with the maximum number of hosts. What subnet mask should you use? Hence the network ID starts from 198. It indicates it is a class C IP address and its by default subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. This is because by default 24 bits are reserved for the network and last 8 bits are reserved for the host. According to question, our main requirement is to find out the minimum 9 subnets with maximum host. It is clearly mentioned in the question that you have to find out minimum 9 subnets. For this reason, we are going to find out the subnets first. The formula for finding the subnet mask is very simple. It is 2 to the power n, where n is equal to number of bits borrowed from the host. Now how many bits should you borrow from the host so that you will get minimum 9 subnets? Let's find out. As it is a class C IP address, so first 24 bits are the network bits, so we have to borrow bits from the last octet. If you borrow 1 bit, you will get 2 to the power 1, which is equal to 2. If you borrow 2 bits, you will get 2 to the power 2, which is equal to 4. Same like this, if you borrow 3 bits, you will get 8. If you borrow 4 bits, you will get 16. So you have to stop at this particular point because 16 is the closest number to number 9. Therefore, the total number of subnets here you will get is 2 to the power 4, which is equal to 16. Now let's find out how many hosts you will get on each subnet. The formula for calculating the number of hosts is also very simple. It is 2 to the power n minus 2, where n is equal to number of remaining host bits. So tell me how many bits are remaining in the host part? We have only 4 bits are remaining, right? So the total number of hosts here you will get is 2 to the power 4 minus 2, that is 16 minus 2, you will get 14. So you will get 14 hosts on each subnets. Now let's find out the subnet mask. The formula for calculating the subnet mask is also very simple. Just you have to count the value of all the network bits. For example, in the first octet, all the 8 bits are reserved for the network. So if you count the value of all of these 8 network bits, that is 2 to the power 7 plus 2 to the power 6 plus 2 to the power 5 till 2 to the power 0, you will get 255. Same like this, in second octet, all the bits are reserved for the network, so here you will get 255. Even in third octet, all the bits are reserved for the network, so even here you will get 255. In the last octet, you have only 4 network bits. So if you count the value of these 4 network bits, that is 2 to the power 7 plus 2 to the power 6 plus 2 to the power 5 plus 2 to the power 4, the total answer you will get is 240. Therefore, 255.255.255.240 is the subnet mask with minimum 9 subnets and maximum host. So guys, hope you have enjoyed watching this video. If you find this video helpful and if you believe that I am able to make you understand this particular one question, then please hit the like button. Now it's time for the surprise test, and our today's question is, You are working with a network that has the network ID of 192.168.10.0. From this, what subnet mask should you use so that you will get minimum 4 subnets with maximum number of hosts? Try to solve this question and let me know the answer in the comment section below, and let's see who is able to pass this surprise test. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video, then please like, share and leave your valuable feedback in the comment section below. And for more amazing tech videos like this, do subscribe to my channel Technical Tech and also hit the bell icon. With that, do not forget to download our Networking Plus Android application. It is absolutely free. Thanks for watching.